Okay, so last time we learned how to hold the bow. Let's review. So that little spot right on the right side of your thumb sits on the little ledge. Those two knuckles, the first knuckles go across from your thumb. Your index finger with the space between index and middle, and your pinky on the top with another space. And that's where you live. The thing when you push down with your bow, when you pull your bow across a string, you want the pressure not to be coming from your arm or your shoulder, but really all you need is from your index finger. So whenever I press down or whenever I want to get louder, I'm really just pressing down with this knuckle. This is what you're going to be doing this week. This is, I know you're going to be like, oh my gosh, let's get to something good, but I want you to do it right. So we're just going to talk about how you pull the bow across a string. So if you're talking about these, we're talking about these four strings, G, D, A, E, right? And you see how, you know, one is higher than the other when you have it, when you have the violin sitting correctly on your shoulder. Your G string right here is the one that's on top. And when you play that one, your arm and your bow are like one plane, like geometry. You think about the plane, a plane in geometry is just one even level. And that's how you keep your hand and your bow and your arm. When your bow is near your face, you bend your wrist as much as you can, so but still keeping it on the same level. Because if you don't bend your wrist, your bow's not going to be straight. So if you look right here, with my wrist not bent, my bow is not straight on the strings. And you want it to be parallel between the fingerboard right here and your bridge. And so if you're going to draw your bow across the string, your wrist has to be bent when it's up near your face. And a good way to practice this is looking in the mirror. If you're standing with the mirror right in front of you, you would have your violin where you could see the whole violin out of the corner of your eye. And then you can actually see that if your bow, if I left my wrist straight, watch what my bow does. It goes crooked, but you want it to be straight. So if it was straight, my wrist would be bent. So you're leading with your wrist. The first thing that starts to bend is your wrist. Your fingers that are in your hand, they always stay like this. They always stay with your thumb bent across from those two knuckles, with your index finger bent and your pinky on top. That never changes. It's your wrist that bends, and then your arm that moves just a tiny bit. Unless you're at the very end, and then you kind of have to, if you're short like me, kind of have to move your hand. All right, so wrist is bent up near your face, and then slowly as you go down, your wrist bends with it. But the thing is, you've got to keep this bow on this plane. It's parallel to the floor if you're on the G string. If you're on the D string, it just changes with where it changes the position to the D string, like this. So I'm still in a plane. There's G, there's D, there's A, and there's E. And E is almost kind of touching your side a little bit. And so you would be drawing down. But you still have that same even plane, nothing changes. So if I played the D string wrong, it might would look like this. See how it looks like a V? That would be wrong. I've got to take my elbow down too. So this is what I want you to do this week. You practice going back and forth on the G string, bending your wrist, and bend it when it comes back to your face, staying totally relaxed. Then change to D, then A, change. plane. Make sure your elbow's down. And then E all the way down. Okay? And then you can change it to go G, then to A, then back to D, then to E. Makes it a little harder. Okay, so that's what you're practicing.